Function, the phase one of general mathematics. So our lesson one is about the understanding concepts of piecewise, rational, exponential, and logarithmic function in real life context. Functions are evident in our daily lives. It is an important concept in mathematics wherein it is necessary for formulating dynamic relationship in the sciences. Functions are the only way through which we can estimate output in math based on the relation among one variable to another. We sometimes may observe that the different theories involving dependency between the quantities can be explained through the idea of function in which its relationship with one another and can be expressed through it. Lastly, to understand the calculus concepts, one should be able to truly understand the idea, use, and importance of functions. Specifically in this session, you should be able to understand concepts of piecewise, rational, exponential, and logarithmic function in a real-life context in which this will be evident. So, in this learning materials, you should be expected to learn the lesson for at least 3 to 4 hours. 2 sessions, we have the synchronous meetings and asynchronous activity within a week. So, we have the following objectives. First, illustrate the piecewise, rational, exponential, and the logarithmic functions. And the second objective is define what is a piecewise, rational, exponential function, and logarithmic function. And the third, we are going to distinguish the following function: piecewise, rational, exponential, and the logarithmic function. Concepts of relation and the function. Before you learn new concepts, let us first revisit the concept of the relation and function, also with the domain and the range. Afterward, some part of the session are the evaluating the function. And this type of concept, you have learned it from your previous lesson in your junior class. Nung kayo nasa junior ano pa, di ba? Category. So, distinguish natin na kung ano yung part na pwedeng magkaparehas or magkaiba yung relation and function. On the column of relation, a rule that relates values from a set of values called the domain to the second set of the values called the range. While on the function, it is a relation where each element of the domain is related to only one value in the range by some rule. Pansinin natin itong ano, naka bold letter siya. Only one. At yung distinguish ng function do sa relation, pansinin mo, yung pagkaka-discuss ng a function is also a relation. Okay? A function is a relation where each element of the domain is related to only one. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, pag na-add na siya ng other one, so hindi na siya tatawagin as a function. Next, on the second part ng column ng relation, the elements of the domain can be imagined as input to a machine that applies a rule to these inputs to generate one or more outputs. Okay, so ang isa pang masasabi natin or ma-identify natin na relation para siyang in-illustrate using a machine. So kung mayroon kang anumang in-input mo dun sa machine, for sure, magkakaroon siya or mag-generate siya ng one or more outputs. On the other hand, pagdating naman sa function, the elements of the domain can be imagined as input to a machine that applies a rule so that each input corresponds to only one output. At tingnan natin yung pagkakaiba. Sa relation, one or more outputs. Diba? Kapag nag-input ka, pag ang naging output ay one or more outputs, ibig sabihin, relation yon. Well, meanwhile, pagdating naman sa function, once na ikaw ay nag-input, expected mo na ang kanyang corresponding output ay only one. Okay? And the last, on the column of relation, a set of ordered pairs, x, y. Okay? So, yun yung kanyang ordered pair sa relation. Meanwhile, pagdating naman sa function, a set of ordered pairs, x, y, such that no two ordered pairs have the same x value but different y values. Okay, so ibig sabihin, kapag gumamit ka ng ordered pairs, para masabi mo na siya ay function, hindi pwedeng magkaroon lang ng one x value tapos marami ang or different y values. So, hindi pwede yung ganong type of ordered pair kasi pag naging ganun yung ordered pair, hindi siya tatawagin function. So, kung hindi man siya tawagin function, ano lang siya? Siya ay relation. Lahat ng mga relation which is not function, still it is a relation. Okay? So, again, so sa part na to, ni-revisit lang natin yung mga discussion about the function. Ito kasi mga previous lesson na to, i-connect lang natin sa ating pinaka-target. Ay, meron kayong question doon sa part na yan? Okay, how about the concepts of a domain and range? The domain can also be considered as a set of permissible values. Permissible values. Ibig sabihin, it is a pwedeng independent. Independent. When a rule is applied to those values, the resulting or equivalent values will be the element of the range. So, nakita natin yung connection ng dalawa, no? Yung domain and range. Once na in-apply na yung rule dun sa domain, na ang values na pwede mong gamitin yung mga permissible values, so, when the rule applied, then magkakaroon ngayon ng result. At yung result, yun yung tatawagin na equivalent values or range. Okay? Okay, let us illustrate these concepts. We use a machine. Ito yung ating machine. Ha? So, dito sa upper part, ito yung ating input. Then, dito naman sa right side ng lower part, nandun yung ating output. So, ang etong machine na to, the machine shows the relation between the length of the side of a square and its perimeter. Ayan. So, yun ang magiging scenario ngayon itong ating machine. Length of the side of a square and its perimeter. Okay, tingnan natin ang magiging input natin. So, ang input natin, any positive number S. So, yung S natin daw represent as the side of a square. So, any positive number. Then, ang magiging rule natin, rule to apply, adding the length of the sides of a square gives its perimeter. Diba kapag, siyempre, ang square naman may four side lang naman yan. So, once na inad mo, or kinuha mo yung total ng four side, yun ay perimeter ng tinatawag natin na figure. Yun na yung kanyang magiging perimeter. Then, ang output natin sa part na to ay a positive number, 4S. O, kasi yun yung sabi sa rule, di ba? Adding the length of the side of the square gives perimeter. E, syempre, ang square naman ay meron lang four side, di ba? That is a part of quadrilateral. So, therefore, ang ating output ay 4S. Meanwhile, sinasabi natin na ang domain ay yung permissible values. So, yun yung nasa part ng input. At siya naman yung tinatawag natin na domain. Okay? Then, doon naman sa part ng output, once na nagkaroon tayo ng domain na permissible values, then in-applied na yung ating rule, itong nasa machine natin, so probably magkakaroon ngayon siya ng output or the resulting values. At yung result value, ito tawag natin na range. Okay, so ano ngayon ang magiging tinatawag natin operation ng machine natin? This can also be considered as a function. Itong scenario na to, we consider that as a function since no two squares with the same length of sides have different perimeter. O, di ba? Wala namang ganong scenario eh. So, ibig sabihin, kung ang two squares ay same length, magiging same din ang kanilang perimeter. Oo. Diba? Hindi pwedeng magkaiba ng length ng side yung dalawang square tapos naging parehas ang kanyang perimeter. Hindi pwedeng mangyari. Okay? So, ito yung sinutukoy natin na function. And again, if it is a function, also it is a relation. Next, okay, tingnan natin yung another scenario. Again, we use the machine as a demo. Ang magiging rule naman natin dito or yung scenario ng ating machine, the machine shows the relation of integers from 2 to 10. Ibig sabihin, yung mga integers in between 2 to 10 and the prime and the composite numbers. Okay. So, tingnan natin yung ating magiging input. Ito yung mga input natin. Kasi yun lang yung ating permissible values, eh, di ba? Ito yung nasa scenario natin, 2 to 10. So, ang permissible natin ay 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then, ang ating magiging rule, given positive integers, oh, di ba yung input natin, lahat naman yan ay mga integers, can only be written as a product of two positive integers, one in itself. Then, it is a prime number. Di ba yung definition ng prime number, ang prime number, ang kanyang factor ay one or a number, one and itself. Yan, okay. Yun lang pwede niya maging factor para ma-declare siya as a prime. Otherwise, kung may more than sa one and itself na factors, kung meron pang additional factors, tatawagin na siya as composite. If the integer can be written as the product of two positive integers other than one and itself, then it is composite number. Diba? Ganun lang naman ang pagkakaiba ng prime number and composite number. Ngayon, ang hinihingi ditong output or result values, prime, comma, composite. Okay? In a set of prime and composite. So, dun sa ating input, kung papansinin natin at titingnan natin, hindi lang isa yung pwede mo makitang prime. Okay? Hindi lang isa. Okay. So, again, ang ating permissible values ay yung integers from 2 to 10. Integers lang, so hindi natin hinahanap yung other number. Then, ang ating output or yung ating range ay prime, comma, composite. Applying the conditions will classify the numbers to either prime or composite numbers. These classifications will be the element of the range. Pansinin natin na sa ating input, sabi ko kanina, di ba, hindi lang isa ang pwede mong makitang prime. May more than one prime. At pag binalikat-balikan natin, doon sa ating set of integers, maraming pwedeng maging prime. Ang una-una na nga dyan ay ang 2, di ba? 2 is a prime. 3 is also a prime number. Ano pa? 5 is also a prime. 7 is a prime number. So, ibig sabihin, meron tayong 4 integers classified as a prime numbers. Then, so ibig sabihin nun, sa definition natin ng function, may invalid yung given scenario. Therefore, ang declaration natin dito sa scenario na to, this relation is not a function. Okay? The relation between the set of integers to prime and comma composite is not a function. Okay, next. Function represented by equation. Function represented by equation. By the way, functions can be represented by equation, and it is denoted by using the f of x equals y. Therefore, an equation y equals 2x plus 5, which shows a relation of numbers represented by x and y, can be considered as a function of f of x equals 2x plus 5. Kasi nga yung ating notation na f of x equals y, so instead na y, pwede natin gamitin yung f of x instead na y. Then, yung ating equation kanina, yung y equals 2x plus 5, ay magiging in the form na ng function. Ito kasing part na to ay in the form of equation. Diba? E pag yung y ay dinamitan natin ng f of x, magiging in the form na siya ng function. Okay, for example, we are going to evaluate the function f of x equals 2x plus 5 given that x is negative 2. Okay? So, ang permissible value natin ay negative 2. Ito yung tinatawag natin permissible value. X negative 2. So, therefore, ito ang magiging tinatawag na domain. Ito yung ating domain. Okay, then we have f of x equals 2x plus 5. Yun yung given equation natin. So, instead na x, ang magiging domain natin ay negative 2. So, yung negative 2 ang magiging input natin doon sa variable x. So, we have f of negative 2. Then, yung operation natin, 2 instead ng x, we use negative 2 as your domain. And then, evaluate muna. Like 2 and negative 2 product is negative 4 plus 5. Negative 4 plus 5 is equal to 1. So, we have f of negative 2. Negative 2 is your input or domain, then the result is 1, then 1 is your output or range. Therefore, the value of the function when x is negative 2 is positive 1. Okay, doon sa nakikita niyong picture, I want you to think of scenarios that can be associated with the pictures and the relations that can be recognized. Okay, so mag-isip kayo ng pwedeng scenario doon sa mga nakikita niyong picture. Then ano yung relations doon sa picture na nakita mo? Okay, so yung first picture natin, ito nakikita niya sa left side. Yung kasi nyo may mga column and rows na nakikita in a form of matrix. In a form of matrix. To determine the function existing in this situation, let us begin with discussing the information available. Ito yung nasa left side. See a picture of public utility jeepneys, pair matrix. Ayan. These tell us the cost of the service given the distance covered in kilometers. To compute the pair, consider the following conditions. Importante yung pair metrics, di ba? Lalo na sa ating mga commuter. Kasi nga, ito yung magiging, kumbaga ay standard. So, ito rin yung magiging basihan. Kaya aware ka kung magkano na pamasahe at kung hanggang saan or magkano ang babayaran mo doon sa iyong bababaan. So, di ba? Lahat nagiging ano, lahat ay nagiging maayos. Si driver, hindi pwedeng magdesisyon ng kanyang sariling pamasahe. Ikaw din, may idea ka rin kung hanggang saan lang ang iyong babayaran. Okay, ito yung ngayon yung condition. The first 4 kilometers of a jeepney ride cost 10 pesos. Oh, siguro ngayon, hindi na 10 pesos na nagtaas na. And each succeeding integer kilometer adds 150 pesos or 1 peso and 50 centavos to the pair. From here, we can identify the relationship between two quantities. That is the relationship between the distance covered in kilometers and its equivalent fare. So ito yung example natin dun sa first picture kanina, yung ating jeepney or yung PUV. Diba? So ang isang pwede natin makita ang relationship doon ay yung distance in kilometer and the equivalent fare. And also, the relationship can be considered as a function because based on the computations, no same distances have different payments unless the driver is unfair and is taking advantage. Totoo naman yun, di ba? Walang na magkapares ng distance, di ba, pares na 5 kilometers, tapos magkaiba yung bayad. Di pwede yun, di ba? Pwede mangyari yon. Kasi meron tayong matrix, eh. Makikita mo dun sa pair matrix. So, pwede kang magreklamo. O bakit ganun? 5 kilometers lang. Ang anong ko, bakit mas mataas yung siningin mo sa akin? Diba? Ganun yung para mangyayari. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, ito ay isang klase ng relation and it is also a function. Given the relation of the cost of travel and the distance covered, which one depends on the other. That is, the cost of travel depends on the distance covered. Diba? So, depende dun sa distance kung magkano yung babayaran na pamasahe. So, sa scenario na to, ang magiging independent variable natin ay yung distance covered in kilometers. Yun yung ating independent variable. Then, ang ating magiging dependent variable, cost of the travel. Kasi hindi mo alam kung magkano babayaran mo, depende nga dun sa kilometer or sa layo ng bababaan mo mula dun sa jeep. So, ibig sabihin, ang magiging domain X natin or yung permissible values natin ay yung distance covered in kilometers. Na yun din ang ating independent. Ay, nakikita niyo yung connection. Yung domain ay yun din ang ating independent variable. Then ang ating namang range, which is y equals f of x, pwedeng range y or pwedeng range f of x, yun naman yung cost of travel. Okay? Okay, to know the specific function present in the situation, let us observe the pattern in relating the values. Note that there is something unusual about how they related. For example, for 4 kilometers, once na-reach na yung 4 kilometers, automatic ang babayaran ay 10 pesos. Base dun sa ating scenario kanina, di ba? Ngayon, pag more than 4 na siya, up to 5, 4 up to 5 kilometers, ibig sabihin, mag-i-increase na ng 1 peso and 50 centavo. So, ibig sabihin, pag umabot na siya ng more than 4, but less than 5, ay magiging 11 pesos and 50 centavos na yung babayaran. Okay? Eh paano sir kung ang kilometer lang ay 'di ba 4.3 kilometers? Magkano ang babayaran? 4.3 kilometers. Yes, ang babayaran pa rin ay 11 peso and 50 centavos. Kasi nga lumampas na ng 4 kilometers. Okay? Basta cover siya ng 4 kilometers up to 5, automatic mag-a-add ng 1 peso and 50 centavos. When covering more than 5, up to 6, then additional uli ng 150. Diba? Kaya yung 11.5 or yung 11 peso and 50 centavos, pag nadagdagan uli natin ng 1 peso and 50 centavos, magiging 13 pesos. So, ibig sabihin, ang bababa mo na hanggang less than 6 kilometer. Okay? Then, pag tinuloy-tuloy natin yon, meron siyang pattern na ma-form. May pattern na mangyayari. And this means that the cost varies depending on the different spans of distance. This kind of situation illustrates a function called the piecewise function. Okay? So, yung ganung pattern na nakikita natin sa ganitong scenario na nagkakaroon ng increases dun sa succeeding kilometer ay tinatawag siya na piecewise function. So, to formally define it, a piecewise function is a function built from pieces of different functions, yo, tinatawag natin siya na sub-functions, over different intervals or subdomains. So, ibig sabihin, itong function ay a function built into pieces. So, kung siya ay may more than one na sub-functions and interval or subdomains, tatawagin na siya as piecewise. Eh dito sa parametrics, pas imposible na maging ano lang to, maging single function lang to. Kaya magkakaroon talaga ng sub function. Kaya we consider it as a piecewise function. Some example of equations of piecewise functions are given below. Okay, so yung nakikita nyo ngayon, meron tayo dalawang dito example ng tinatawag natin piecewise functions. Yung nasa left, f of x is equals to ax plus b in yung first sub function. Ang kanyang interval ay where x greater than 0. Yung interval natin, yung x greater than 0, yun naman tinatawag natin subdomain. Then yung another sub-function niya, cx plus d, where x is less than or equal to 0. Okay? So again, it is an example of a piecewise kasi binubuo siya ng two sub-functions. Then yung nasa right side naman, f of x equals to, meron na tayong three sub-function. Yung first sub-function natin, x minus 1, where x approaching or greater than or equal to 3, yun yung kanyang subdomain. Then 2 plus x yung second sub function, ang kanyang domain naman ay a number x in between negative 1 less than or equal to x and less than 3. Yun yung kanyang condition on the sub domain. And the last sub function x square where x is less than negative 1. Okay? Yan. So yun yung mga tinatawag natin example of the piecewise functions. Okay, next picture tayo. Yung first picture natin ay para doon sa piecewise. Ito naman yung kanina, yung nasa top right. Top right ng ating four pictures. Okay, so dito, pwede natin sabihin ano, moving car. Okay, depende kung siya by slow or fast moving car. Let's have another scenario, determining the function existing in this situation. Scientifically, the speed of moving objects can be computed. The speed can be thought of as the rate of which an object covers distance. It is the ratio of distance over time. So a formula can be used to compute speed. By illustration, we have the speed is equal to the ratio of distance per time. Consider the situation wherein you are investigating the speed of a car covering fixed distance. So the speed depends on the time to cover the fixed distance. So ang dependent variable natin dito ay yung speed. Yun yung dependent variable. Kasi di ba, magkakaroon lang naman ng speed depende sa ratio ng distance and time. Kung walang distance and time, walang speed. Kaya siya yung dependent variable. While our independent variable naman ay yung time. Kasi meron naman tayong fixed distance. So constant yung distance, kaya ang magiging independent natin ay yung time. So yung time ang magkakaroon ng permissible values. So for instance, ang magiging domain natin yung time, kasi siya yung permissible values. Yun ang domain natin. On the other hand, ang magiging range natin ay yung speed. Okay. So ang range natin ay speed at yung domain naman natin ay yung time. Okay, so specifically, we call it a rational function. A rational function is a function of the form f of x is equals to the ratio of p of x over q of x, where p of x and q of x are polynomial functions, and the q of x is not the zero polynomial, or q of x is not equal to zero. So the domain of f of x is all values of x where q of x is not zero. Ito yung formal definition natin ng rational function. So yung speed is equals to distance per time ay yon ang tinatawag na, yung scenario na yon, yon ay example ng rational function. Or yung tinatawag na real example ng rational function. We can say that a rational function forms a ratio or a fraction of two expressions. Some example equations of rational function are given below. Ayan. So f of x equals 10 over x. That is a rational function. Kasi yung 10, at 10 we consider as it is a polynomial. Polynomial of 0 degree. Ayan, yung 10. At yung x naman, it is a polynomial of 1 degree. Or yung tinatawag natin linear function. So, check. Isa siyang rational function. Then, the other way around, itong second example natin, f of x equals x squared minus 5. X squared minus 5 is a quadratic function over 2x plus 3. 2x plus 3 is a linear function. And, numerator is a polynomial. Denominator is also a polynomial. Therefore, it is a rational function. So next, ito naman yung nasa third figure natin kanina dun sa may lower left. Yan, ito yung merong day 0 up to day 6. Another situation in determining the function existing in the given situation is the growth of bacteria in a period of time. Many times, scientists will start with a certain number of bacteria or animals and watch how the population grows. When a quantity increases by a fixed percentage each time, the amount y of the quantity after t periods is given by y is equals to a quantity 1 plus p raised to t. So this illustrates a function where our independent variable or the domain is the time of the population growth. The time of the population growth, yun yung ating independent at yun din ang ating domain. Ayan. Time of the population growth. And the dependent variable of, or the range ay yung amount of quantity. Ayan, amount of quantity. Ah, yes, may tanong si, ano, si Claire.
Sir, ano po, pwede po bang paki-explain po ng maayos?
Ano daw, paki-explain daw ng ano?
Nang maayos, paki-explain.
Okay, so to know the specific function present in the situation, an example of a population that doubles every 5 days. This means that the longer days that the bacteria is present in the specific container, the population of the bacteria present in the given substance also increases or doubles every 5 days. So this is an example of the exponential function. Okay, let us begin the basic definition of exponential function. An exponential function with the base b is a function of the form f of x is equals to b raised to x or y is equals to b raised to x, where b is greater than 0 but not equal to 1. Ito lang yung definition natin ng exponential function. So yung rapid growth na nangyayari dito sa ating bacteria, sabi doon ay double increase, di ba? Doble yung pagtaas, depende sa bilang ng araw. Every 5 days, mas dumudoble yung bilang ng bacteria. So yun yung mga tinatawag natin yung example ng exponential function. Okay? Okay, last picture natin, itong yung kanina, nasa last part ng ating picture. So the magnitude of an earthquake may depend on the energy released by the earthquake. This is one scenario wherein we can determine the kind of function existing in this scenario. In 1935, Charles Richter proposed a logarithmic scale to measure the intensity of an earthquake. He defined the magnitude of an earthquake as a function of its amplitude or on a standard seismograph. The formula below produces the same result, but it is based on the energy released by an earthquake. So ito yung na-discover ni Charles Richter na earthquake magnitude on what we call a Richter scale. The magnitude R of an earthquake is given by, ayan, okay, so ang gagamitin doon sa model na to ay yung kay Charles Richter. Ito yung kanyang, ang purpose naman ito ay to find the magnitude R. Okay, so ito yung kanyang equation na na-form. R is equals to 2/3 logarithm E over 10 raised to 4.40. Where E in joules. So yung sukat niya ay in joules. Is the energy released by the earthquake. The quantity 10 raised to 4.4 joules is the energy released by a very small reference earthquake. Ayan, okay? So, ito ay kinuha natin sa isang, ang reference natin ito ay isang calculus book. No, reference natin. to know the specific function present in the situation. An example of the recent happened in Davao City last January 2022, which has a magnitude of 5.4. The magnitude was determined after knowing the amount of energy released. Since the magnitude, that is the range, varies depending on the energy released and by the earthquake, and that's the domain. So then this illustrates a function specifically called the logarithmic function. Okay? So ibig sabihin, sa case or sa scenario pala ng earthquake, nagagamit din ng isang function na tinatawag natin ngayon na logarithmic function. Lalo na kapag kinukuha yung magnitude nung isang earthquake gamit ang Richter scale. Okay? Let's have the basic definition of this function. Itong tinatawag natin logarithmic function. So a logarithmic function with base b is a function of the form where b is greater than 0 and b is not equal to 1. So ito yung form natin ng logarithmic function. F of x equals to logarithm of x with base b.